Last week on Skillcapped, we covered the topic of old dungeons that would make for exciting keystones. As part of that, I went on and on about how impressed I was with the updates made to Throne of the Tides in Season 3. There was, however, one minor detail that I omitted. People hate the new Throne of the Tides. I hate the new Throne of the Tides. For all the work that went into it and all the flowery prose last week, it's just not a particularly fun keystone. And, like, this isn't a quirk unique to Throne. If I just toss up a list of every old dungeon that got re-released in Dragonflight, there's some stinkers here. This is relevant because old dungeons haven't been, like, some small experimental thing being done on the side. They've been the majority of keys in the rotation this expansion. They have, for better or worse, defined keystones for the last year and a half. So, as fun as it is to get all teary-eyed and nostalgic at the prospect of doing the Steam Vault plus 20, we should probably scrutinize this. Because we're both smart people, we could solve some amount of problems if we felt like it. So let's have today a facts and logic debate, a rational discussion about the merits of old dungeons. Today, people typically love old dungeons being used as keystones. And look, I'm not one to brag, but I was saying this stuff years ago. I swear that's true. I logged into the BFA beta and I saw they removed the Legion keys and I was like, ah, but I wanted a 30 dungeon set. World of Warcraft was a trailblazer in online gaming, and the modern live service model owes a lot to WoW. The Celestial Steed walked so $25 Fortnite skins could run. But one dynamic unique to WoW is its enormous content rot. Blizzard will release a raid, it will be the singular raid for 6 to 12 months, and then it's rendered obsolete by the next raid. Dungeons have historically gotten off a bit better, but it's the same idea. Necrotic Wake is released, we run it for 2 years straight until we hate it, and then it's banished from relevance. This made sense in, like, 2006, when each expansion included a leap in technology so vast that it genuinely made content feel kinda obsolete. In just 5 years, we went from Marudon to the Forge of Souls. But there's been diminishing returns on this for a long time. Does the Underrot feel 5 years older than Halls of Infusion? Not really. Rather than being banished for being crap, we banish content now as part of the routine. And that does not deliver shareholder value. And thankfully, blessedly even, Activision Blizzard King has picked up on this in recent years. Blizzard toyed with the concept of re-releasing dungeons in Season 4 of Shadowlands, and they seemingly fell in love with it. Of the 32 dungeons that have been in the Mythic Plus rotation since August of 2022, 20 of them have been re-releases. This seems to have been enormously popular amongst players, the stated reason often being that these dungeons add variety to the expansion's 5-man content. It spares us from running the same dungeon for 2 years straight. This has somewhat serendipitously come at a time of increasing disdain towards keystone affixes. Historically, it was affixes that was the solution to the variety problem, whether it be sanguine, tyrannical, a seasonal affix like beguiling, or all of the above simultaneously. That was your variety whenever you ran Toll de Gore. However, it's clear that players don't want their dungeon runs to be defined by the affix rotation, because in practice, variety becomes instability. It's good weeks, bad weeks, and annoying edge cases. Public sentiment towards affixes continues to sour, and Blizzard has responded by making the affixes less impactful. Old dungeons arrived on the scene just in time to fill that role and spare us from having to run Legacy of Tear for 2 years, not even the courtesy of a seasonal affix. But in a strange way, we've swung aggressively from overusing dungeons to now underusing them. Battle for Azeroth seasonal content ran for around 25 months. That's 25 months of Atal Dazar, Waycrest, Manor, and so on. Season 1 and 2 of Dragonflight average out to around 5 months each, with Season 4 unlikely to go any longer. Even if we count Season 4 as a genuine season that will see genuine engagement, I don't because it won't, Dragonflight's dungeon set will be in rotation for less than a year. I'm sorry, are you telling me that that's value for the shareholders? For real? On God? We sort of hurried these dungeons out the door, didn't we? And that was so we could enter Year 3 of Darkheart Thicket or the Underrot. Good keys for sure, but dungeons that players have seen a lot. The problem is that this solution deliberately phases out new content for old. Brackenhide Hollow was kept fresh by bringing in Black Rook Hold. The variety argument begins to break down if Brackenhide hangs around. It has to go to the farm, basically. But maybe you're picturing Halls of Infusion right now, so you love all this. But how about Algathur Academy, a key that's considered by many to be an all-time great? It's hard not to feel like we've kind of wasted it. So in the short term, it worked. Rotating Dragonflight dungeons out prevented us from resenting them, but the core practice still remains. We're still going to discard these dungeons like any other expansion in a couple of months' time. The only real difference is that it feels like these dungeons still have quite a bit to give. In terms of shareholder value, of course. But then, maybe they don't. Okay, I've got to be careful with how I phrase this next part. Game development is hard. Blizzard, like many AAA studios, has a culture of crunch and systemic layoffs. Stuff only gets made if developers are assigned to make it. So with that said, if you were higher up at Blizzard, assigning production resources in Battle for Azeroth, you knew that those dungeons had to stand up to scrutiny for two full Gregorian years. Those suckers had to own, because if they sucked, you were stuck with them until you made new ones. And you know, like as a thought exercise, hypothetically, maybe even, if you knew these dungeons would only be in circulation for 4 to 6 months, maybe you'd be okay telling yourself that it's okay if they're a bit shit. Maybe, deep in your heart, you know that Nakut Offensive is the lamest thing ever created. But you have other things to worry about, and besides, it'll be replaced with the Vortex Pinnacle in a few months. And yeah, maybe the Vortex Pinnacle isn't good either, but players only need to live with it for like 6 months, and it'll be replaced with Darkheart Thicket, which yes, isn't very good. Maybe it's just me, but it feels like a lot of the excitement around old dungeons is specifically rooted in a dislike of the new dungeons. And maybe it's at least worth considering that there's a feedback loop there that we're feeding into this system. Just some thoughts for the next shareholder meeting. Now, we can bully game developers all day long. It's a sacred pastime, but let's turn that energy inward. Do we actually like Underrot? How about Halls of Atonement or Mechagong Junkyard? Look, I'm not a judgmental person. I'm actually quite a humble thought leader. But other people, excluding yourself of course, they let the lizard brain tell them what keys to like, and the lizard brain wants to minimize suffering. So like, you know, your rep paladin, his favorite key is Shadow Moon Burial Grounds, because he lets the lizard brain control him. And it's pathetic, really. Personally, I've learned to control the lizard brain. I leave my hand on the hot stove just to assert dominance. So if the lizard brain theory holds true, then people only like old keys because they're easy, right? And that seems intuitive at first. But as it turns out, it's more complicated than that, because of course it bloody is. It's always bloody too complicated. Difficulty is a messy word. In the traditional sense, it would refer to the complexity of the combat. So like Eridacron, with all his mechanics and his multiple phases, is more complex and thus more difficult than Rukhran. Despite Eridacron arguably being the most complex dungeon boss of all time, Galakrond's Fall was consistently among the easiest Tyrannical Keys in Season 3. Because complex and difficult aren't synonymous when it comes to Mythic Plus. This is intuitive to anyone who's pushed keys before. Learning to kill the bosses is not the objective of Mythic Plus. Arguably, it's a prerequisite. M Plus is about taking dungeons you are already familiar with and seeing just how high you can crank up the difficulty slider. And that causes tuning to get a little weird. We want to cover this in more detail in the future, so we're going to keep it broad for this video. But if a boss only has one ability, that ability needs to hit hard for the fight to be dangerous. This tends to be the case for most of these 10 plus year old boss fights. Look at a boss like Everbloom's Ancient Protectors. The entire fight comes down to two mechanics. You drop green circles and you kick every possible cast. Or do you remember Shire of Doubt with that magic debuff that had healers molding on Twitter for weeks? That was the boss's only mechanic in phase one. It was absurd. Both of these fights come down to fundamental skills, kicking, dispelling, defensive management. For skilled coordinated groups, this isn't difficult, but the margin for error was non-existent. You either kick every cast or you get murked by a water bolt to the face. This has really weird implications for dungeon difficulty, creating huge variances from boss to boss. The last three dungeons of Everbloom are all brutal, but then you have just Witherbark chilling at the front. Ataldazar, easiest key of all time until you get to the new Yasmo, who might actually be the most difficult dungeon encounter of all. In fact, if we look at some snapshots from Subcreate, God rest its soul, we can see an obvious trend in dungeon difficulty. We can see how the S tier is made up exclusively of old dungeons. Every season, re-released dungeons are the easiest key, and at the same time, the lower tiers are disproportionately clogged up by old dungeons. Now, given that we're being objective here, this data has been selected for maximum rationality. There are no flaws in my methodology, and I will not be taking notes at this time. And what this objective data shows is exactly what a lot of us feel intuitively. Old dungeons bias toward either being too easy or too hard. They're either free IO or the key you avoid. Shadow Moon Burial Grounds or Everbloom. And rarely anything in between. And you know, sure, new dungeons aren't inherently more balanced than old dungeons, but if Blizzard can't get thrown above a D tier, even with all the work they put into it, maybe old dungeons are just cursed, you know? And look at all those dungeons in the A tier. A for awesome. If Blizzard just makes a new dungeon, it's guaranteed to be balanced. Just look at the data. The data is... Like, I can't do it anymore. And I gotta be honest, man, this isn't facts. It's not even logic. That data analysis from earlier, it's stupid. Don't do that, it'll get you thrown out of school. But, you know, most people, I don't give a shit about the shareholders. You know, like, the stock was dealers 6 months ago. Do they even have shareholders anymore? Like, Ian, if you're watching this, do you still answer to the shareholders? Tell us what they're liking, and leave a comment and tell us what the shareholders are like. And you can tell I don't care, because this was the best outfit I could come up with on short note. Who mixes these three colors? Jesus. Old dungeons scare me. I'm ashamed to admit it because it's not rational, but it's genuine. And let me tell you why. You ever play Runes of Magic? No? Dark Age of Camelot? Not ringing any bells? How about Fiesta Online? Tell me you've at least played Fiesta Online. No, it's fine. Don't worry about it. I did the homework. I've played all these games and many more like them. And let me tell you, they have a weird energy about them. MMOs have enormous upfront development costs. For years, we saw companies risk everything to create the mythological WoW killer. An easy example would be Star Wars The Old Republic. That was BioWare, fresh off of Mass Effect, making a Star Wars MMO for EA. Its $200 million budget made it one of the most expensive games ever made. Over the course of its life, The Old Republic has made well over $1 billion in profit. But as the years have gone on, the game has been serving an ever-shrinking user base. As a result, development of the game has slowed, and in 2023, EA shifted development of The Old Republic from BioWare to a company called Broadsword Online Games. Broadsword is a company who specializes in maintaining old MMOs. They take these expensive games that have already been built and keep the games running for the benefit of what players remain. When an MMO reaches a company like Daybreak or Broadsword, development on that game functionally ends. The Old Republic had its last expansion in 2021, and it will not get another. These are companies whose business model is taking something built by a lot of people and maintaining it with a small number of people. So these are companies that specialize in, you know, server hardware and customer support, and they'll maintain, you know, as many MMOs as they can possibly manage at the one time. They do offer some new content just to give the game some sort of pulse, but they do so through very cost-effective means, typically seasonal events cobbled together by recycling assets. Like, this footage from Dark Age of Camelot will be very familiar to any WoW private server players. Not that I would know, of course. Here, Runes of Magic had a clothing festival going on, whatever that means. It's hard to explain, but when you're inside Runes of Magic, you can tell that it's dead. But you also feel that there's someone outside doing chest compressions, fighting to keep the blood flowing for just another fiscal period. It's not that I dislike old dungeons being reused as keystones, or WoW Classic, or Season of Discovery. It's just when I look at them, I'm reminded of these MMOs in Caretaker mode. And that's not logical, that's not rational, that's not even particularly fair to the people who make the games. It's not a reason to not do it. I look at Activision Blizzard's continuous massive layoffs and worry that some dickhead in a suit is going to quietly wind down the dungeon dev team by leaning more and more on pre-existing content. And what if he already has? What if in the false banquet of recycled dungeons, we just haven't noticed yet? I had very similar anxieties coming out of Wards of Draenor, and what made Legion feel so special for me personally was how it completely silenced all of those concerns about the game's future. It was expansive and expensive, and we were bombarded with content, you know, constantly. The quality of the content we can maybe debate. Like, you know, I won't say it was all top shelf, but I think we can agree that like Blizzard projected enormous strength around that time. Last week we spoke about how More of Souls made a huge statement about the production value of Mythic Plus. As much as I would love my Onkahead or Steam Vault keystone, they aren't sexy, they aren't powerful. They almost betray the promise made by More of Souls. Rather than getting to do my favourite old dungeons as keys, what I want is for my favourite dungeon to be a new key, a dungeon that I want to run for 2 years straight. As we're editing this, alleged slides from WoW's GDC talk have just been leaked. They seem to suggest that WoW is in the strongest position it's been in a long time, and it's gotten there off the back of recycling content, whether it be Wrath Classic or reusing keystones. Like Dark Age of Camelot, WoW is not going anywhere. I don't fear WoW's literal death, I fear a creative death. Physically, there is nothing stopping Blizzard from re-releasing A Tale to Zar and making the next great key for the War Within. Those two things can easily coexist, physically. But is it spiritually possible? How does a band release their best album after the greatest hit CD? This video is propaganda. You just watched propaganda. Why? Because at Skillcapped, we specialize in offering high-quality World of Warcraft guides that take our subscribers to the next level. Every season, our team is at the coalface to keep up with content updates and trends to keep you on the cutting edge. So if Blizzard just keeps re-releasing old dungeons, we'll all be out of a bloody job, mate. But maybe not, because we have a deal going right now where subscribers get a monthly VOD review with one of our experts. You can learn more over at skillcap.com. And remember, you are not immune to propaganda.